Hi, Internet. Welcome to the Gradtron YouTube channel. It's Thin Lizzy Thursday. So this week, we actually have some Thin Lizzy news. So Darren Warden, who played keyboards in Thin Lizzy and was on Chinatown as a studio musician, but then toured with the band and then officially joined as a full band member for Renegade and Thunder and Lightning, is forming a new band, which is going to be called Renegade after the first official album. Darren Warden was credited as a band member, but his second album with Lizzy. So he was on three Lizzy albums, which is more than Gary Moore. So, you know, just a weird little fun fact. So Darren Warden is forming a band where he's going to be playing Thin Lizzy songs, focused primarily on his era with the band, but also some of their biggest hits from other albums. And, just keeping the music of Phil alive and just, you know, it's definitely very cool because, you know, he was, you know, he joined Thin Lizzy at the age of 18 when he was, you know, just a kid. And so obviously that was, you know, very formative to him. That was like his first, you know, major gig and sort of dictated the rest of his life after that. And so, looks like he's going to be doing some touring, under the name Renegade. So hopefully that project goes well for him. You know, Darren's keyboards, I have mixed feelings on, and I don't necessarily like what they add to the Thin Lizzy sound in a bunch of the albums he appears upon. Like, I listen to it, and it's like, it doesn't go well and add to the band in a way that I like. It's a different musical element. It changes the band's sound, and I don't think it's necessarily for the better. I think it unfortunately stands out in a lot of ways and actually made some of the material weaker with his keyboards. Not all the time, and like he's a great player, but I think some of the musical choices didn't necessarily benefit the material. But you know, wishing him all the positivity and luck with that endeavor. And this week, doing the audience vote. And we are doing Sha-La-La off of Nightlife, which, spoiler alert, I think these lyrics are dumb. These are, as far as Thin Lizzy lyrics that are I would actively consider bad, this is one of the songs. A strange kind of magic, call it voodoo. You want that woman, yes you do. Believe me, baby, I know it's true. Come on, sugar, let me give it to you. Black magic woman, you've got a hole. Come on, sugar, I'll lose control. I want your body, not your soul. Come on, baby, take my jelly roll. These are awful lyrics. This is lyrically F rank. I can't even. Black magic woman, you've got a hole. Come on, that is trash. Using jelly roll as a sexual metaphor is just is bad. Generally when a rock band sings about voodoo, it is generally bad. It's terrible. This is a terrible lyric. This makes Kiss lyrics look good by comparison. This makes most hair metal look good by comparison. Like, this is remarkably bad lyricism. Like, it is absolutely awful. Musically, it's pretty great. It's a great song. But yeah, the lyrics are trash. So let's dive into the song, shall we? Yeah, so this song is pretty much carried entirely by how cool it sounds. And then if you actually look at the words, it's just like, ooh, that's cringe. But, you know, Phil was actually given a good vocal for these trash lyrics. Like, he's doing a very good job with the vocal. And musically, it's killer. This is sort of one of the first songs in the Lizzy catalog that really sounds like what people think of as the Thin Lizzy sound. Like, this has got, you know, the dual harmony guitars. It's got the pulsating, you know, rhythm section. It's hard. It's heavy. It has a great groove to it. Like, it has all the musical elements of the heavier side of Lizzy, and also, like, that slight funk edge. But what the song is really missing that most Thin Lizzy songs have is great lyricism. This song is missing a crucial component of the Thin Lizzy gumbo, where it has the sound of classic Thin Lizzy. It fits in well in a live set. It's very cool musically, but there is nothing of worth here in the lyrics. Like, absolutely nothing. It's a good vocal. And I like the way that Phil, you know, says sha-la-la-la-la-la. Like, that's cool. But there is literally nothing worthwhile in the lyrics of this piece. Okay, the line, "I want your body, not your soul," is, you can argue that one line is a good line in the sense that it shows a pure, like, lust, and I think that is a valid topic to tackle lyrically, and that actually, that line can be considered a bit clever in the sense that, like, it shows that it is purely lust. There's no romanticism here. It is all, it, and, like, that is, I will give that one line as being a, you know, good line. However, it's surrounded by a bunch of terrible lines, and that one good line isn't good enough to counteract the bad lines surrounding it. So you could have, like, had an interesting concept for a song about someone who is, you know, purely consumed by lust. That could be an interesting lyrical direction to take, but this is not interesting lyrically. Come on, baby, take my chair. Alright, so that is Sha-La-La by Thin Lizzy. So, the primary songwriter is actually listed as Brian Downey with Lynott as a co-write. So I wonder, man, did Brian write these lyrics? Is this the mind of a drummer? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, it's. So musically, it is fantastic. It is prime Thin Lizzy doing what Thin Lizzy does best. Like it's, I every musical component of the song was excellent. And so, if you're ranking this like purely on the music, you've got S rank across the board. Like every section was great. Every single section musically was fantastic. And I listen to a lot of music with bad lyrics. I listen to a lot of hair metal. I listen to a lot of Kiss. And so if lyrics are so bad that I like it takes me out of the song, they're really bad. These are like not just like some of the worst Thin Lizzy lyrics. Like these are some of the worst lyrics I've heard in like a song, like period. You've got one good line and the rest is hot garbage. And so it makes it difficult because like, musically like it cooks, and generally with music, I tend to give a pass for bad lyrics where I'm just like, ah, whatever, at least the song is cool, which is a way that a lot of people are. But with Thin Lizzy, the bar is set higher because most of the songs have really good lyrics. And so when you have a song that's like this bad lyrically, it stands out. If this was like a Kiss song, it might stand out as being like really cool musically and wouldn't stand out that much lyrically. So like, okay, all right, whatever, it's another bad Gene Simmons song. But because you've got these lyrics in the Lizzy catalog, it does stand out. And if anyone likes these lyrics and thinks they're good, you're just wrong. There's one good line. I will give you one good line. I will be reasonable and say there is one good lyric in the song, but the rest of the lyrics are so bad that that one good lyric is actually brought down by the rest of them, and it's only good in isolation, not in the context of the song. It's still a bad line. So yeah, we are being harsh on this one today. Let's see. Now we see where do we rank it. Let's see. I mean, it's musically, I can't like. It's not gonna. Let's see. Okay, so musically it's better than Killer on the Loose. So it's at least A rank in terms of music. I mean, lyrically, like it is F rank. So do I split the difference or do I judge it like based upon the musicality, the great playing, whatever? All right. Okay, so I'd say it's better musically than say Bound for Glory. So it's like okay, so it's not better musically than Emerald. So let's try to find where it winds up. Wild One. I do like it better musically than Wild One, even though the lyrics are way better. King's Vengeance. No, I like King's Vengeance musically and lyrically more. So, do I take the lyricism of Wild One or do I take the musicality of Sha-La-La? You know what? I don't like the soul of Sha-La-La, but I do like the body. I like the surface level musicality, but the soul of the song, the lyricism, is not great. But I mean, yeah, it's a musically it cooks. It cooks musically. I mean, it's a rocker. It's awesome. But lyrically, it is trash. Yeah, definitely curious on to the comments in this one. That is a very interesting reaction where it's just like I just spent the entire time ragging on it and say like, oh, this is terrible, and then it's A rank. So, but that's the honest commentary on this channel. All right, stick around next week for the random song, and yep, I'll see you guys in the comments. Bye, everyone.